You are welcome to this second episode of the teaching series on the church's victorious living at the end times. And in the first episode, we sought to bring information and awareness regarding the times that we are in, using Nehemiah and the building of the wall of Jerusalem as example, that he recognized and was aware that they were living in war times, challenging times, despite the fact that their primary assignment was to build the wall that was broken down. We shall read from the book of 2 Timothy chapter 3. And in this second episode, we seek to bring to us the features of the times that we are in. Now, the people of the Lord are often on the negative side, and they are destroyed because they are not aware, they are ignorant of the times that they are in. Now, 2 Timothy chapter 3 identifies the features of the times that we are in. And because the times are perilous times, the end times, and God has made provision for our victorious living, we need to be aware of what we are up and against. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 1 reads, "This know also, that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying the power thereof. From such, turn away." Now, from this portion of the scriptures, we see that the features that characterize or identify the times that we are in are listed out. Now, because Paul here was writing to Timothy, who was overseeing the work of God at Ephesus, in the spirit of the time of the end. Now, this letter was written with the end times in view. The Lord brought them into the scenario of the end times by situations around them, and then in the spirit of prophecy, he projected to the time of the end, which times we are in now, to see and then identify the features which we need to know. Now, when the Bible says that, "Know also that in the last days perilous times shall come," that word perilous time is taken from the word, single word, peril. And that word peril means dangerous times. There is a translation of the Bible that says it's a time when it will be difficult to be a Christian. And truly, if we look around today, all the features that are characterized and listed here actually indicate to us that living as a Christian is not child's play. It is as though everything around us conspires against our godly living. Everything around us conspires against our righteous living. Now, when we say we are in war times and perilous times, it may not necessarily mean that there will be shootings all around us, although we are seeing that. There has hardly been any time when the whole entire globe was, you know, in turmoil and restless as we are now. But more importantly is the fact that the war we are talking about is spiritual warfare. There are forces of darkness, there are powers of darkness that are seeking to frustrate the power, the programs, and the purposes of God. And any child of God that steps out for God, they are ready to frustrate you, they are ready to cut you down. Because Satan is referred to as the adversary of the brethren and the adversary of the purposes of God. Nevertheless, having listed these features that identify these times of the end, I'd like to pick on one, which is in verse 5. It says, "Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof." And then the apostolic injunction is, "From such, turn away." There has never been a time that we have a religious people as we have today in our nation, in the entire globe. People are religious, you know, passionate about one deity, one religion or the other. But this has not actually brought peace on the earth. This has not actually brought the expected change in the man and in the society. So, but the Lord desires that those of us that have known the Lord Jesus Christ, we should not deny the power. Because Paul said, the gospel is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes. As a child of God, there are, just let us be aware, there are dangerous times that we are in. But God has given us the power and the seed of Christ within us to be able to live above the times victoriously. The Lord bless your heart in Jesus' name. Amen.